Welcome back to my channel. I'm Dr. Shruti Vasishta. If you're new here, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Today's video is going to be about a topic that is very important from your practical examination point of view, that is the instruments. Under RGHS examinations, the instruments carry 10 marks. So whenever you are given an instrument, you are expected to identify the instrument, name the parts and list few uses of it. You might be asked a few questions related to it. For example, if you get an episiotomy scissor, you might be asked about the layers cut during episiotomy or the degrees of perineal tear, like that. Since most of you are not being able to attend the labor postings and the OT, I think this is going to be helpful to you all. So let's start.
Sims double-bladed non-self-retracting vaginal speculum. It has two blades of unequal size and a groove which allows drainage of secretion. It is used to visualize posterior vaginal wall, to inspect the cervix and vagina, to detect any injury following delivery, to clean the vagina following delivery, to visualize local causes of bleeding and during D&E operation. Sims anterior vaginal wall retractor. It has loop with serrations at both the ends. It is used to visualize the anterior vaginal wall along with the Sims posterior vaginal speculum. Cusco's bivalve self-retaining vaginal speculum. It is used to visualize the cervix and vagina for bleeding, to inspect the cervix and to detect leakage of phlica in case of premature rupture of membranes, that is PROM. Cocker's hemostatic forceps. As you can see, it has tooth on one end and groove on the other end. It has a catch. It is used to clamp umbilical cord and in low rupture of membranes for induction or augmentation of labor. This is a multiple tooth valsalum. It is a long curved instrument. You can see the multiple teeth on both the blades. It has a catch. It is used in D&C operation, suction evacuation and in the removal of polyp and a fibroid. The most common instrument, the sponge holding forceps. It has ring shaped ends with transverse serrations. It has a catch. It is used to clean the vulva and vagina before and after delivery for antiseptic painting of parts and to catch hold of the cervix for inspection of any cervical tear. Babcock forceps. It has non-crushing ends and a catch is present. It is used to catch the fallopian tubes in tubectomy operation. Tissue forceps, you can see the catch and the ends are sharp here. It is used in D&C operation to hold the tip of an episiotomy wound, to hold the margins of the peritoneum and rectus sheath, and to hold the torn ends of sphincter ani in case of a perineal tear. Uterine sound. It is an olive pointed, graduated, metallic and malleable instrument. It is used as the first dilator of the cervix to assess the uterine cavity length and to detect if there is any IOCD. Heggar's dilator. The number on the dilator represents its diameter. It is used in D&C. This is a punch biopsy forceps, which is used to take cervical biopsy in case of chronic cervicitis or suspected malignancy. Needle holder. It is used to grasp the needle during suturing. An episiotomy scissor is used to cut the skin and tissues during episiotomy. Blunt tip goes inside the vagina. Green Armitage hemostatic forceps. It has got broad serrated end to hold the tissues. It is used in lower segment C-section operation to achieve hemostasis. Leech Wilkinson cannula. It has a conical tip. The cone is screwed into the cervix. It is used in tubal patency tests for infertility, like hysterosalpingography or laparoscopic rhomoperturbation. Uterine curette. You can see it has a sharp end and blunt end. The blunt end is used for curettage. It is used in D&C operation and evacuation of hydratiform mole. Only self-retaining catheter. The catheter tip has two openings for draining urine. And at the other end, there is one port for distilled water insufflation and other to be connected to the urobag. Red rubber catheter, it is used to empty bladder in retention of urine. Copper T380A, 380 indicates the surface area and A means that the copper is present in the arms. Doyen's retractor, it has a wide retracting blade. It is used to retract the abdominal wall during LSCS operation. Artery forceps, it is used to achieve hemostasis by grasping the vessels.
Although it looks very simple, it becomes difficult when you keep it for the last moment. So keep on revising whenever you can so that you don't forget. I hope you like this video, so don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel for more content. See you soon. Until then, bye.